Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm going to talk to you today about how former Asian American of the Black Panthers, Richard Aoki, he was an FBI informant. In spite of what Asian American professor at UC Santa Barbara, she's chairwoman, of the Asian American department, Diane Fugino, she vociferously denies that he's not. What first she did, now she says he may have been at first, but he was won over to the radical movements. But I have arguments to counter her on this, okay? A guy by the name of Seth Rosenfeld wrote a book talking about the radical movements and the FBI's surveillance program, COINTELPRO. Well, Seth Rosenfeld, one of the key agents that he interviewed for this book was Wesley Swearingen. And Wesley Swearingen saw a picture of Richard Aoki and said, he was my informant. I developed him. And Bernie Threadgill confirmed that. They were both FBI agents, and Wesley Swearingen was actually very critical of the FBI's COINTELPRO during the 1960s. He actually vacated the conviction of former Black Panther Elmer Geronimo Pratt. So Wesley Swearingen really had nothing to gain by saying that Richard Aoki was an FBI informant, but Wesley Swearingen said that he was. Bernie Threadgill said that he was. Now, on the telephone interview that was recorded, Seth Rosenfeld asked Richard Aoki, was he an FBI informant? He said no. He first denied it, but then he said the issue is complex, layer upon layer. Okay? And Seth Rosenfeld sued the FBI 5 times. And under the Freedom of Information Act, he was able to get these files. And the FBI produced tons and tons of files proving that Richard Aoki was an FBI informant. Okay? Now, we'll go further, okay? And Richard Aoki is one of his alma maters, that's to say. He went to Merritt College first, and then he transferred to UC Berkeley. Well, Merritt College was like a community college. Well, Merritt College confirmed in their video after they interviewed Aoki that Aoki was an FBI informant, okay? It started to get revealed that Richard Aoki was an FBI informant in 2007, when 2009, he committed suicide. Richard Aoki committed suicide, and before he committed suicide, he was a soldier in the Army before he went to college. He laid out his Army uniform, and he laid out his Black Panther uniform, then he committed suicide. Okay, my question is, why did he commit suicide so soon after it was revealed that he was an FBI informant? Okay, why, and the FBI wasn't trying to reveal this, but why was the FBI able to produce a bunch of files to Seth Rosenfeld, which they didn't want to reveal, but Seth Rosenfeld sued him 5 times to get it? Why was the FBI able to produce so many files on Richard Aoki if Richard Aoki was not an FBI informant? It just doesn't add up. And it doesn't add up as to why Richard Aoki was not an FBI informant. And also, when Aoki was a professor of college for a while, he had FBI, and this was his own admission, he had undercover agents in his classrooms that were armed. So they had to protect him for some reason. There were undercover people in Aoki's classes ready to protect Aoki at a moment's notice. So something had to be going on to where he was an FBI informant. This is why I say Professor Diane Fugino is wrong to think that he's not an FBI informant, where the evidence is just laid out there, blatant and obvious that he was. Anyways, hope everyone's doing well. Take care. God bless them. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.